Pauling politiko po ulit ito para lalo po natin manamnam. Blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the wicked, nor stands in the way of sinners, nor sits in the seat of scoffers. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and on his law he meditates day and night. He is like a tree planted by streams of water that yields its fruit in season, and its leaf does not wither. In all that he does, he prospers. So what we have learned about grow, bypassingly, again, as a review, God is commanding us to grow up. Huh? To fully grow, to be adult, to be mature. Yan po ang utos sa atin ng ating Lord. And not just to grow up, to grow, to be like Christ. No? Hindi po yung dating niya. Ang sinasabi dito yung character of our Lord Jesus Christ. Ano niyo ba ang totality of character ng ating Lord Jesus Christ? It's all about love. No? Then, ano po yung means of growing? Sabi natin, pag-aralan natin, it is first read the Bible, then prayer, worship, fellowship, witness. Ito po yung limang pinaka-importante sa buhay po ng isang mananampalataya, mga kapatid. We have also learned that to lack the five means of growth, we will not grow completely. This is not the will of God. No? Hindi po itong kalooban ng Diyos. Okay? Now, last Sunday, we studied about glow. Sabi natin, we have learned that our lives as children of God, followers of Christ, disciples of the Lord must be manifested. Nakikita. No? Now, that is the meaning of life. It reveals, it shows, it points out, it gives directions, it instructs, it shows the truth. No? That's making Christians different from the world. Napag-aralan din natin last Sunday na first, we are created and saved to do good works for God's pleasure. Second, we are empowered to do good works for God's pleasure. Third, we are fully pleasing God with good works and we will know more of Him. And fourth, we are commanded to do good works being God's people. Now, we are in the last part. Go! Mga kapatid, if you have your Bibles with you, kindly open it with me in Matthew chapter 28, verses 19 and 20. Kung kayo po ay nandun na, just say Amen. Matthew 28, 19 and 20. Natulungan na lang tayo. Bumagal yata yung Androids natin. Ipo, I'd like to request everyone to please stand up as we read these words. I'd like to read it with you in English Standard Version. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you, and behold, I am with you always, to the end of the age. Tayo po manalangin. It is our desire, O Lord, to learn from you once again. O Lord, we'd like to hear from you. Banal na Espiritu, sa iyong mga salita, kami po ay iyong tuluan, O Diyos. Inaamin po namin, we do not have the power to understand your words. Only you can give us the power to understand yours, O Lord. Holy Spirit, allow us to hear from you this morning. Katulad po ng panalangin, Lord, ni Moses and ni David, Lord, allow us to meet you face to face this morning. Hear from you, learn from you. Holy Spirit, Hinili po namin that you open our hearts, open our eyes, open our ears, na maging discerning and maging accepting kami sa iyong word, sa iyong tuturo, sa mga katotohanan ng iyong salita, O Diyos. And Lord, may these words and may this truth, Lord, not just that we will learn, give us also your empowerment, O Holy Spirit, that we may outlive this, Lord. Live out, Lord God, all these truths in our lives, Lord. May these things cause us to manifest the truth. And may these learnings, Lord, cause us to go as you have commanded us. Thank you, Lord. We trust you this time. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Tayo pumako po na, mga.
Go!
Napalo po, mga kapatid, that we learn, ano po ba yung tema ng Bible, ng Lord, tapos pagkakasami niya ng word na go. Sa Greek word po, ang go ay poriomahi. Poriomahi. No? That's how we pronounce it. Ang meaning po ng go na poriomahi in English, that is journey, walk. No? Now, this is in an active form. No? Active form ang go dito, mga kapatid. Okay? So this is how we should translate it. Sabi niya, in your going, then disciple. Sabi ho yan sa Aramaic Bible. If you like to look at it sa original context of it, ang sinasabi ng go and make disciples sa original sinasabi niya, in your going. No? Make disciples. Gusto ko yung paano nilagay ng ISV. Sabi niya ganito, therefore, as you go. No? So, ano yung sinasabi sa atin ito ngayon? What does this say to us, mga kapatid? Ang gusto sabihin ngayon sa atin dito, mga kapatid, as we do things, as we live our individual lives, as we face our everyday lives, we do live and face it in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Nasasunod niyo? Kasi sabi dun sa original context, in your going, active form, para sinasabing, habang ginagawa mo ang lahat, habang lumalakad ka, do this, in Jesus' name. Nasusundan natin? As we face our lives, we, no, that's going already. Nasusundan niyo? Tutulog, gigising, that's going. No? Kasi, meron po tayong maling pananaw dati, pagdating sa go, ang ibig kong sabihin ng go agad, parang sinasabing mission agad eh. Magmi-mission ka, pupunta ka sa isang lugar, and you will evangelize, and you will share the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. Wala pong problema doon. Okay po yun. Pero yun po ay, alam mo, ikinakahon mo lang po yung word ng going sa isang aspeto na kailangan mag-mission ka lang. So ngayon, ang pananaw natin ngayon, kapag ka hindi ako nakapag-mission, hindi ako, I am not going. Nasusundan ninyo? No, sinasabi ng Bible dito, as we face our everyday lives. Yun nga yung sinasabi, in your going. Yun nga yung sinasabi ng Bible, as you go, as you walk, as you live your life, do it in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Nasasundan na rin? Huh? And then, ang pang sasabihin, as we relate to our loved ones, as we relate with our neighbors, as we relate to our relatives, friends, office mates, church mates, etc. As we relate to different people, old and new. No? Bago man yan, o luma man yan. Matanda man yan, o bata man yan. No? We do it in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Hello? Nasusunod each other, that's going already. Nanusun na niya? Ha? Kaya nga ba sabi ng Lord sa Colossians chapter 3 verses 16 and 17, I'd like you to read it carefully. Sabi niya, let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, teaching and admonishing one another in all wisdom, singing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs. Look at this. With thankfulness in your hearts, and whatever you do, in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father for Him. Huh? Sa totoo lang, itong verse